My hello. Tonight, we'll be cooking chicken tikka marsala. That's right, a wonderful Indian meal for you and yours to cook at home. It's very easy, surprisingly.
We already have 3 boneless chicken breasts sliced and diced into little bitty cubes or so, cooking. You'll also be needing some tikka marsala curry paste. This is made by a company called Batox, which sounds like a Klingon insult. You can fetch such wonderful things from your local Indian market if you have such thing. I have such thing nearby because I live in Atlanta. You want some plain yogurt, non-flavored. Then to make it the way I make it, you want onions, mushrooms, peppers, and some jalapenos, if you so care to. Your can of stuff will have a recipe on the back if you so should like to listen to them. Or, you know, you can listen to me. Whatever. But I also recommend you go and get some naan. What is naan? Who the fuck knows? No, actually we do know. It's bread. It's flat bread. This is made by a company called Shuri Punjab. That sounds like a joke to me, but I'm not gonna make it. He looks actually kind of Italian. I don't know what the fuck's up with that, but it's tasty. Well, our chicken is still cooking. Needs to cook a little bit more. Well, the chicken is almost done now. Time to start adding some of this stuff. You could add either the vegetables first, or the yogurt, or the paste, whichever you prefer. Alright, first, personally, I'll be adding the paste. Sometimes it comes out one nice big piece, but apparently it's too much of a son of a bitch, you cocksucker. Alright. There's more than one way to do that. You can get your spoon, fork, make the shit come out. Get my fucking gillet, you bastard. Son of a bitch. Alright, you add that, then you get your this stuff. Your yogurt. Put that in. Alright. Now that you have the paste and the yogurt in, you stir it up real good. Yogurt gives it kind of a creamy texture. The paste has kind of a texture of pesto sauce, if you've ever used that or seen it. Once you've stirred it up good, start adding your vegetables. Stir them in. Then you need to add a little water. Water will make it soupier. Normally this is a pretty soupy little meal, but I prefer it not to be so soupy. And also, since I add vegetables in there, they will cook down and the water will come out of them into the food. So I like to use a little bit less water than most recipes call for. Stir it in, make it all good. Keep cooking it for a little while, maybe 5 minutes on a lower temperature, not on high, maybe medium. Let it all kind of blend together. The vegetables cook down a little bit. Now, since this is almost done, you would take your naan, a couple pieces of your naan. It's already cooked, fully cooked, you don't have to cook it anymore. But I recommend warming it up in the oven. Let them sit in there 5 minutes, a little less than 5 minutes, just want them warm. After a couple of minutes, take your pieces of naan out. Personally, the way I eat it, you don't have to eat it the way I do. You can just eat it like that, it's very tasty. But I personally like to do it this way. I take my naan and I apply the chicken tikka marsala to the naan, like so. And make a tasty sandwich. I like to spread it all out so your bread sucks up a lot of the juice. Then you get like a normal pita. Stick that in your mouth and eat it. Yummy. Nom, 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 nom.
I'm feeling yummy head to toe. You see me, ain't got no patience, so let's go. You see me, look, I'm diet drama. Wanna spend the night, don't bring pajamas. Man, there's so much heat beneath these clothes. You see me, walk in the place. They know my face, encore, sophomore. Only one solo, I swore.